morning, everyone. It's Tiffany here again with a new lesson video. Give me just a second and I'll pull up the verse. Okay, our verse comes from Romans 1:16. It says, I am not ashamed of the gospel. Okay, so the gospel is the good news that Jesus forgives us when we believe in him. So what this verse is telling us is that we are not ashamed. Now, what does ashamed mean? So ashamed means a kind of a feeling of embarrassment, or guilt, or reluctance, or fear of something. But we are not embarrassed. We are not reluctant. So to understand the meaning of ashamed a little bit more, I kind of came up with a fictional situation to help you maybe understand it just a little bit better. So say that you are at the playground playing and you see your best friend Susie come to the playground and you yell, Susie, Susie, hi, come over and play with me. And she looks at you and then she looks down and maybe looks away and she doesn't respond to you and she walks away. Now, how would that make you feel? For me, I would feel like sad and upset and probably a little confused. Why my best friend Susie didn't want to play with me. So this is an example of Susie maybe feeling embarrassed or ashamed, sort of. So Jesus is telling us he does not want us to feel ashamed, as example of Susie feeling ashamed. He is telling us he doesn't want us to look down and to not come play. He wants us to believe in him. He wants us to believe in the gospel. He wants us to shout to the world that we love Jesus. So this is what the verse is saying. So today we're going to kind of go over our commitment to follow Jesus. So what does this mean, to commit to follow Jesus? So our story today comes from Mark 8:31 through 38. Okay, so here is Mark 8:31 through 38. Just a quick look at it. And now we are going to go over what it says and what it means. So our story today is about the disciples. Now, who were the disciples? They were men who chose to follow Jesus. Now, how many disciples were there? Does anybody know? Feel free to comment below with your answer. Okay, so let's go ahead and get into our Bible story. Again, it comes from Mark 8:31 through 38. Now, in this verse, Jesus is speaking to his disciples, okay, our little Jesus, and he is telling them things that they might not want to hear. So in this, in these verses, he's explained to them what's going to happen to him. Now, Jesus already knew that he was going to be hung on the cross and killed, but then come back to life in 3 days. So he was telling his followers who had committed their lives to him and his word that these things were going to happen. Now, I don't know about you, but if somebody would tell me these things, I'm not sure how I would feel. I would probably feel very shocked, maybe angry, confused. So these disciples are hearing this from Jesus about what is about to happen to him. And they're in disbelief at this point. I mean, they have faith in Jesus, but they can't understand why these things are going to happen. Okay, so Peter, one of the disciples, became angry and he kind of pulled Jesus aside and he started to scold him. Now, what does scold mean? It kind of means you're kind of talking to somebody angrily. You're upset, so you're being angry. So he starts to scold him and it basically tells him, don't talk like this. But Jesus turns to him and says, Peter, you aren't thinking about what God wants. This is God's plan. Remember, this is God's plan. So he says, you aren't thinking about what God wants. You're thinking about what you want. And it's true. I mean, Peter didn't want these things to happen to Jesus. None of the disciples did. I mean, nobody wanted this to happen, but God had a bigger plan. And Jesus knew. He knew that these were the things that were going to happen to him, but they were necessary because when he died on the cross for us, he saved us from our sins. Okay, so in the verse, Jesus is speaking to the crowd and he says, whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. So what does this mean, to take up your cross? When you give up something that you would rather have or do and do what God wants you to do, that is how you take up your cross. Okay, so for example, say you are in the lunchroom and you have your lunch all out and you're ready to eat, and your best friend, we'll use Susie again, your best friend is sitting next to you and she forgot her lunch. Now, I'm sure that you would much rather eat your lunch and fill your belly, but you feel in your heart that God is telling you that you need to share. You need to share your food with your friend Susie. Now, this is how you're kind of denying yourself something that you might want, but you are doing something good for someone else. And that is definitely what Jesus would want us to do. Okay, so we commit to follow Jesus by taking up our crosses. This is what he is telling us to do. And by telling people about Jesus and bringing them to church and really spreading the word, this is what he wants for us. Okay, so let's take a look at our verse one more time. I am not ashamed of the gospel, Romans 1:16. And our story again came from Mark 8:31-38. Okay, so for our challenge this week, I would like you to write down or draw one thing that you can maybe give up for a friend or a family. This is our way we take up our cross for Jesus. A second challenge for this week would be to lead your family in a prayer and ask God to help you follow Jesus. Okay, or you could tell a friend that you follow Jesus, and maybe they'll ask you questions and you can tell them what he has done in your life, and maybe they'll ask to join you at church sometime. Okay, and so now before we go, I would like to say a prayer, but before that, I am going to go ahead and leave a free printable activity again in the descriptions. I have a copy here, and it's just a fun little activity to kind of do at home if you would like. And it does say, I choose to follow Jesus. Okay. They have just different things that you can fill in. And I would love, again, as always, to see these. I'm actually going to have my kids complete these, and we're going to have a fun little conversation. And I would love to see what you guys end up doing with these. So again, bring them in on Sunday. I have a whole bag of treats that I'm waiting to give out. So I would love to see them. Okay, so let's go ahead and bow our heads and pray, please. Jesus, we love so many different things about you. Thank you for everything you've done for us. Please help us with completing our challenges this week, and help us to tell others about your love. And as always, please help us to follow you in every aspect of our lives. We love you so much. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. I definitely enjoyed learning right alongside of you. And I will see you next week for a new video. Bye. Have a great week.